this video I will talk about Seaborn. So, in contrast to ggplot, Seaborn abstracts this grammar of graphics away to normal Python function calls with normal arguments. So it's more how you would expect your Python to look like. In principle, it should give you most functionality ggplot has, but generally I don't use it for that many plots, even though I really like how it looks. So we import Seaborn as SNS, and when we call Seaborn.set, we set the styling and behavior of the plots. If we call it without any arguments, we just use the defaults. And you're going to notice that as soon as we call Seaborn.set, even matplotlib plots change how they look to the Seaborn style, which we saw here in Pandas a couple of videos ago. So let's reload our data set. And let's first start with the scatterplot matrix of all numeric variables with a single function call. And that's like the one I always do Seaborn for. So the pair plot. So here we see the single variables as histograms, and here we see all the pairs of variables. So if it's categorical against numerical, we see that we simply have on the grid, we have these numerical continuous points. And if they're both numerical, well, we simply have a scatterplot. We also have this aesthetics mapping, and we can, again, like we did in ggplot, use, for example, a categorical variable for the color. However, here it can only be categorical ones. So with keyword arguments, we set the aesthetics. For example, we set hue equals origin, and now we have three variables in one plot again. In Seaborn, we can also explore single variables. For example, we can use the displot. So that's now the standard Seaborn style here. And once I reload it to show the distribution of this one acceleration variable, and we see here that this is more how we call Python, right? We take the pandas dataset cars at the column acceleration. This is how we normally call stuff in Python, in Pythonic code. We can use a box plot where we say we want the acceleration column from the dataset cars. Yes, we can also explore the relation of one continuous to one categorical by simply saying we want a box plot where x codes the origin, y codes the acceleration from the dataset cars, and now if the one is categorical, we have three different box plots. We can make a swarm plot, which is a nice alternative to jitter, which looks more like a violin plot, but where it has the points next to each other if there are many. That's a really nice plot in my opinion. And we can overlay them by simply calling one function after another. It's not as convenient as the aesthetics mapping, has to be specified again, but there's also ways around that. But we can simply plot one after the other. Here, Seaborn style, and we have both in the same plot. Of course, violin plots are there as well. And yes. Okay, then there's this nice feature that I can have, if I have binary variables, I can make this split violin plot. So if I make a binary variable where I simply split my age variable into the categories old or young, so 50%, the lower 50% are old, the other 50% are young. Now if I say split equals true, I'm splitting by the binary variable. That's a really nice thing, and I can have both plots next to each other. So split equals true for hue age means split at the hue variable. Just like in ggplot, we can of course explore the relation of two continuous variables in Seaborn, and we do this, for example, with a join plot, which is simply a scatter plot with histograms on both sides. I'm going to simply tell it I want the dataset cars, and on the x-axis I want the column horsepower, and on the y-axis I want the weight in pounds. So scatter plot plus histograms. Again, this is prone to overfitting because here we have many points on the same position, and a nice plot which Seaborn provides with one argument is simply the join plot, which is basically a two-dimensional histogram as you see here, and this is another nice way to avoid this overplotting. So we simply tell it kind equals plot, and now we have this nice plot. Then we can also say we want a regression, and this gives us a regression line again with confidence intervals for the join plot, as well as a regression line for each individual histogram here on the sides. And also kernel density estimation, we also saw that in ggplot already. Another kind of plot is the linear model plot. Again, x-axis, y-axis dataset, which gives me a linear model. More details about linear models in 2 weeks. Okay, also, just like ggplot, seaborne supports this faceting using the cul and row argument. So we simply specify on the x-axis I want horsepower, on the y-axis I want the weight, and the categorical variable column is supposed to be encoded in, the categorical variable origin is supposed to be encoded in the columns. Now it generates these three plots automatically. And we see this is one line of code, one command, which is simple, and it automatically creates the titles and the axis descriptions and three plots without looping. It's a really nice thing. Okay, also in seaborne we can make more complex facet plots by using this facet grid. And then we first create a facet grid, and then we map a plotting function to the respective subplots. Again, we can map categorical data and colors, but again, only categorical data. I showed that before. So this reads, we want to make a facet grid where we encode the cylinders in the row. So these here are gonna be the number of cylinders, 3, 4, 5, etc. And on the columns, we encode the year as integer, which we created here. So this year is then the combination cylinders 3, year this, blah, blah. And the hue is supposed to be encode the origin. Categorically, that's how it's possible. And then we create this grid, and this has already three variables encoded. And then we simply map, use grid.map, and then some plotting function, for example, this matplotlib.hist function, and the variable which we want to plot here. So now we have four variables. We have cylinders, the year's integer, the origin, and the horsepower. And we have we have columns, we have rows, we have colors, and we have a histogram. And then we add the legend here. So create a facet grid and then map the function to the respective grid elements. Okay, and that's already it. Like I said, I just want to go real quick through seaborne. So I have one exercise for you in seaborne. That's make a violin plot for each variety in the barley data sets. Split the box plot by color for the 2 years. So this is how it's supposed to look. All right. So what we can do here is we can make a seaborne.violin plot using our data set barley, where on the y-axis we want to encode the variety, and well, obviously on the x-axis, no wait, on the x-axis we want the variety, and on the y-axis we want our result, the yield, and then we want to split, yes, and we want to split by hue equals yield. Now this is our plot. So now we see, it's nice that you can create it with one statement, but now we have the labels here overlapping each other, and that's a bit shitty, and that's why we're looking at how to customize this with matplotlib real quick. But first, so like I said, I use seaborne when I know there's a plot for this where I can make a command in one line. And this is why seaborne has this example gallery. This one here. So I look into the example gallery of seaborne and I'm like, okay, yeah, I kind of want precisely this plot. And then I look at the few lines of codes this plot is created with. And then also the tutorials and reference page here. So it has first of all the complete API reference, complete tutorials, and also API reference and tutorials for each of its features, and that's really nice. So categorical tutorials, and it lists me here, you can make the strip plot, you can make a box plot, violin plot, etc, etc, and then it lists me here how the plots look. Really nice for the plots that are implemented in seaborne. I really always use seaborne for these kinds of plots because it's really quick and looks really nice.